I've still been told I'm the messenger, and I'm here to deliver the message from the President, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency Muhammad Buhari, GC. The Speaker of Parliament, every representative by my colleague and my brother, the Right Honourable Wasu, President of the 74th Session of the United Nations General Assembly, His Excellency Tijani Mohamed Bande, congratulations once again. Honourable Members, Parliament, my colleagues, the Ministers of Health and Foreign Affairs, Your Excellencies, Members of the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure and a rare opportunity to be here today. This memorable and important occasion to declare open the conference that will dwell on the ways of the lives and welfare of the older persons in Africa's sub-region living groups. As you all know, aging is a lifelong process that is initiated and terminated by nature. But in between the two major stages in the process, a number of developments take place. Those processes of human interaction with one another, deprivations occur and sacrifices are made by others. Such deprivations, either on the part of the state of individual, always result human rights abuses and violations. These are considered to be vices and inimical to societal growth and development. Globally, the general trends in the aging process are identical, but the approaches adopted by different governments determine the extent of human rights compliances of the older persons in the country. In every traditional African society, older persons are well respected and given a place of honor. Africans have been known to provide welfare for the older ones in the society through the immediate extended family system. Even the traditional administrative structure recognizes the roles of older persons. This is reflected in the appointment of traditional rulers in some African communities. Some rulers in some African communities who are older persons are consulted regularly and their opinions are heard very hard. However, Western civilizations, some of these traditional practices that bestow honor and respect on our older persons are on the decline. It is the duty of Africans to bring back such glory and honor to their older ones. We cannot afford. We cannot afford. Our hands and expect others to do this for us. This conference has come up to take up such responsibilities. Therefore, I urge all African countries here present or represented to take back their home countries that we need to wake up to the challenges of older persons in the region. We also need to collaborate and join efforts with other nations of the world, including the international community, to fight for the rights of older persons globally. In an effort towards addressing the rights of older persons in Nigeria, the Nigerian government has put up some measures, which include 1. The Senior Citizens Act of 2018. This act was signed into law in January 2018. It mandates all tiers of government to establish national citizens centers. These centers will provide and facilitate care, training, orientation and reorientation for the older ones. This will bring about optimal utilization of the expertise and potential of the older person. You can also learn and benefit from the wealth of experiences as acquired in the aging process. This also can strengthen intergenerational support and solidarity among different ages. 2, pension scheme. There have been challenges in the administration of pension benefits for older persons who have served and retired from service, either in the public or private sectors. The pension reforms of 2014 sought to improve pensions administration and introduce the contributory pension scheme. In furtherance of this, the Nigerian government introduced the Pension Transition Arrangement Scheme to harmonize pension issues that may arise from the transition from the old to the new scheme. Though retirees still face some challenges in accessing prompt and timely pension benefits, the scheme has witnessed unprecedented improvement in pension administration. The Chairman of Pension Commission and pensioners are witness to such improvements. Government is working hard towards addressing other challenges. 3, pre-retirement training. Public officers in Nigeria are giving pre-retirement training to enable them to invest their pension benefits and engage in meaningful economic activities. This is a strategy aimed at eradicating poverty in old age. Other benefits the government is looking into are subsidized medical expenses in public hospitals and social welfare services. 4, conditional cash transfer. The Nigerian government, through the Empower program, has been able to identify some older persons who enjoy the monthly periodic cash disbursement as sustenance stipends. The scheme is aimed at assisting and providing support 1 million Nigerians who are poor and vulnerable. In order to effectively manage and implement the scheme, the National Social Register was created. The biometric and demographic data of beneficiaries are reflected in this register. This scheme has identified over 2 million poor and vulnerable households and registered over 1 million persons, including the older persons. Over 1.5 million of these people have been enrolled and registered and are currently benefiting from the scheme. In addition to this, 500 caregivers from our 10,000 communities have been captured in the scheme, and more than 50,000 of them have been trained qualified community. facilitators. This is to address the challenges encountered by the older persons, especially in the areas of health. It is important to remind ourselves, as Africans, that care for the older persons is culturally and traditionally rooted, highly respected in African societies. Nigeria is not an exception to this, as it is still the case in our country. However, modalities and approaches, these are frequently reviewed to address the current and peculiar realities of modality and civilization. However, such approaches and methods must fall within limits that will safeguard the primary objective, which is care and human rights of the older persons. At the regional level, Nigeria collaborates with other African countries and organizations on policies and programs that aim at improving the human rights of older persons in the region. This conference is one of such activities where relevant ministries and agencies are collaborating to develop a document that will give Africa a common platform at the open-ended working group at the UN in April 2020. Also, the federal government is studying the protocol to the African Charter on Human and People's Rights on the rights of older persons in Africa, and this will be ratified in due course. 5, Economic Growth and Recovery Fund. As contained in the 2002 Agreed Plan of Action on Aging, some key priorities are older persons and development, advancing health and well-being into old age, to ensure enabling and supportive environment. The federal government has mainstreamed welfare of older persons into a policy framework that addresses short, medium, and long-term economic development. This provides opportunities for older persons to participate in social and economic development and on the human rights platform. But also to recall that Nigeria aligned with positions adopted by G77 and China at the 9th Open-Ended Working Group on Aging in New York in a presentation by Nigeria's permanent representative, President of the United Nations General Assembly, His Excellency at Home, Professor Tijani Muhammadu Bello. Finally, I wish you fruitful deliberations. I hope that you can come up with recommendations that enable African governments at national, regional, and international level to develop and implement policies that will improve the human rights situations of older persons. Thank you. God bless. Basically from my work, and therefore it is my honor and pleasure on behalf of Mr. President to declare this